Using an entry macro in SwiftUI is incredibly easy because it abstracts away the boilerplate code and lets you focus on building your app's UI faster and cleaner. With just a single line, you can define your app's starting point without worrying about setup details. In this video, we'll go in depth in why entry macros simplify SwiftUI development so much and walk you through a step-by-step example to show exactly how to use them in your own projects. And if you want to master SwiftUI in 4 weeks, go ahead and check out the discounted link in the description. More on this later in the video. Today, we are going to talk about the SwiftUI's macro. So what I have done over here is just created a basically demo project. Well, it's an empty one, basically. What we want to do is just have an observable object, and that would be available through the @environment macro. Now, there are a couple of ways of doing that, and we are going to get till the end of the video how to use the entry macro. So first of all, let's create our observable object. Well, it's an observable, it's not an observable object. You will see in just a second. So let's just create a new empty file. And there we go. And let's just call this app controller. And then let's import SwiftUI. And this will be an @observable, there we go, class, and app controller. We don't need the LS object, so let's remove that. And what I'm going to do is, let's just have a text. So var text and hello world, that's perfectly fine. Okay, so we have our observable. How can we add this onto our application, basically onto our content view currently? As an environment. Well, I like to do that outside of the content view, and we are going to have that @state private var app controller equals app controller. And now that we have this app controller as a state, we can just assign it as .environment app controller on the content view itself. Now, just a note right over here, if you are adding a navigation stack, then you should add the environment onto the navigation stack. Okay, so we have our environment set up. Now we can go into the content view and let's just access it. And we do that by adding the @environment. And then just go app controller, so your class name .self, and then private var, and then app controller. So this is how we get access to it. Now, let's just add here a text so we can see that it's actually right over there, text, and then app controller dot text. Really nice. Now let's build and run and see what that looks like. And basically we should just see that text from the observable being presented on our content view. And remember, this is accessed through the environment. Want to supercharge your SwiftUI skills? SwiftUI Camp is back, my top-rated cohort-based Zoom bootcamp, and it's your faster path to building real production-ready iOS apps. For a limited time, you can join at a massive 80% discount, but only until May the 7th. In just 4 weeks, you'll get live, hands-on guidance, pro-level tips, and the confidence to launch your own app or score your next dev gig. Spots are limited, so don't wait. Hit the link in the description and claim your seat now. Here we go. Hello world. As expected, we have hello world right over here, and we have that as the text on our view. Really nice. Okay, that's fine, but this is just one way of accessing through the environment. There's another one, @environment, and then we have /dot, and then dismiss. I want to have something like this. I really like this kind of syntax, so that's where the entry comes in. But before that, there was another way of building it, and let's start with understanding how that's built, and then we are going to get to the entry. Okay, so what we need to do is just create an app controller key, so that controller's key, observable object's key, and then extend the environment value. So let's do that one step at a time. I'm just going to do this right over here. Feel free to just add it into a separate file. So we are going to have a struct, app controller key, And this is going to be pre-concurrency, so not with Swift 6. So we want to add at pre-concurrency, and it will be an environment key. Okay, so now we want to have a default value. Well, actually the default value, but with the main actor. So at main actor, and then static var, no, let me just type it out. Auto completion is messing things up currently. So static let default value, and not value, but equals our app controller. There we go. So this is our default value on the environment key. Next up, we want to add an extension on the environment values. So extension, environment values, and let's just see if we have this public var app controller. Yeah, it looks like it's doing. Let me just hit tab over here. We don't need inlineable, and also we don't need the public right over here. Let's just see. Yeah, so this should be fine. App controller of type app controller get and set, and we are going to get the app controller key from self when we are getting it. And when we are setting it, we are going to set the new value onto that key. Okay, so now that we have these two in place, so the app controller key, the environment key, and the extension of the environment values, now we can access our app controller a little bit differently. So let me just, I'm just going to start adding it and then I'm going to comment it out. So at environment, and then we can go backward slash dot and then app controller. As you can see, it's already available for us to use. And then private var app controller, not two, but just simple app controller. And I'm just going to comment it out. And if we build and run right now, we'll see the same effect. So it's really, really nice. This has been used before the entry macro has been introduced, and also after. So you can use it even after. But of course, today we are going to learn how to use the entry macro, because it's a little bit easier to just build out these things with the help of the macro. So again, we have the hello world on the text, that's fine. So this is a little bit, you know, a lot of code, and it's boilerplate code. You have to write this over and over again. So a macro came with SwiftUI, and it's really simple to use. So instead of this, I'm not going to comment it out just now, but we are going to add an extension on the environment values. Okay, and instead of adding this app controller with the key that we have created, we are going to add an at entry and then var app controller equals app controller. So basically we are just taking this default value and this app controller and putting it into one. So let me just comment it out. So, you know, there is no redeclaration of the app controller. And now this should also work. So let's build and run once more. It has succeeded, really great. And hello world, there it is. So the entry is basically doing the same thing as the environment key plus the extension on the environment values. So we can also expand on the macro, so we can take a look at what it actually does. So right click on the entry macro and select expand macro. And there we go. As you can see, this is really familiar. We have a get and set for the key app controller. So this has been set under the hood by the macro. And then we have the default value, which is really, really nice. Yeah, this is what macros are. They just hide unnecessarily overused boilerplate code under the hood. So it's really, really amazing. So yeah, this is how easy it is. This code and this code has been replaced with the just one liner of entry right over here. And remember, this is added to the observable that we have created earlier. Now, if you like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out SwiftUI Camp. I have an 80% discount link down in the description.